Sometimes less is more. Sometimes you don't need a discrete GPU for quality gaming. Sometimes all you need is a beefy APU. This is the AMD Ryzen 5 5600G, and we've partnered with AMD to discuss its architecture and capabilities in this video. And spoiler, it packs one heck of a punch for the price. We wouldn't be doing this, making this video, if that wasn't the case. See, in a world where graphics cards are in high demand and most of us are, well, at least on some kind of reasonable budget, releases like these are quite refreshing. Not only do they not break the bank, at least relatively speaking, they're also widely available. Chances are you could hop online and buy one right now without having to deal with crazy price gouging. Now that seems like a weird pro in 2021, but it is what it is. So knowing that going into this, I'd say the 5600G is a pretty darn good place to start for an entry-level gaming PC, as it is relatively attainable in relation to most discrete graphics options out there. Now, as for architecture and features, let's start with the basic architectural layout and its advantages over previous APUs. So AMD recently released two 5000 series APUs. We have the 5600G, this one here, and the Ryzen 7 5700G. Now, the 5600G, if you ask me, is the more value bang for the buck option. It's got 6 cores, 12 threads, base frequency of 3.9 gigahertz, max 4.4, and 19 megs of cache. The 5700G, on the other hand, bumps things up to 8 cores and 16 threads, we're talking CPU cores here, and a max frequency of 4.6 gigahertz and 20 megabytes of L3 cache. TDPs are identical and both have unlocked multipliers for added fun if you're into overclocking. No overclocking tax you'll need to pay with either of these. But apart from the obvious CPU core disparity, there's really only one other small difference physically between these two, and that's the number of compute units. See, the 5600G here has 7 of these, and these are essentially dedicated graphics cores. The 5700G has 8, along with a slightly higher frequency. And we'd expect performance to scale roughly in line with this number. So not a huge disparity in graphical horsepower, though we'd expect the 5700G to have a distinct advantage in other multi-threaded applications like, say, video editing, streaming, and encoding. Also bear in mind that these chips are reliant on Zen 3 architecture for their CPU cores, which means you'll enjoy a healthy latency reduction over that of previous APU generations, thanks to unified L3 cache and an 8-core per CCX array, meaning core-to-core communication need not travel across the Infinity Fabric first. This ultimately translates to more efficient processing time and higher frame rates in games, all other things equal. Less latency equals good. As we just mentioned, AMD decided to send us the 5600G, which I would have opted for anyway, seeing as though it is the more attainable chip without too large a compromise in the graphics department on paper. And with it in the box, you'll find a stealth cooler, which can help keep the budget in check when building a system. You don't need to spend any extra for an extra CPU cooler. The rig we've put together also won't break the bank. Again, relatively speaking, we wanted to balance things out. It doesn't make sense to pair a $1,000 platform with a chip like this. So it is quite balanced, and I think it still packs quite the punch for 720p and 1080p modern gaming. So let's see what this thing can do. So this here is our affordable gaming rig, again with the 5600G in here using the stealth cooler, and you can see that, well, we've no graphics card. It might look a bit weird at first, but there are actually plenty of advantages going with a build like this that doesn't have a discrete card. Again, apart from the things we just mentioned about availability and price gouging and things like that, especially in 2021, you can also build extremely compact systems with this configuration. But I've chosen this configuration here because I feel it's a little more indicative of what the average gaming PC builder would assemble. We've got an MATX case, MATX motherboard, decent entry-level power supply. You don't really need anything fancy when building something like this. And at the end of the day, it's still gonna, again, pack a punch in games, which I wanna talk about next. So I wanna kick things off first with CSGO, which I think is a pretty popular title, especially for an APU of this caliber. You can see we are hovering well over 100 FPS. Yes, pretty much the entire session here, and I apologize. My gameplay is it's pretty lackluster. Sometimes I get a little overconfident, and then I start playing with bots in this game, and I realize that I am just absolute trash. But anyway, I can't really fault the the frame rate here because we're well over 100 FPS. And the in-game settings here, I think, are turned up to high in 1080p. So that's pretty darn good if you're into competitive titles like CSGO. The 5600G is more than enough for your needs. Next, we've Dirt 5. Now, this is a modern off-road arcade-style racing game. I wanted to show you guys in 1080p what to expect with this APU. You can see our GPU is pretty much pegged at 100% throughout this benchmark. And that's just a result, again, of trying to keep in-game settings as high as possible. And again, the 1080p resolution here. Our CPU cores are just kind of, Yeah, just kind of sitting on the back burner, just hanging out. There's still plenty of CPU horsepower waiting to be leveraged, and this game is more graphically intensive here, which is why we are headed around 30 to 40 FPS in this title. Of course, I could have dropped this to 720p and it would have been much more playable. You'd have seen a lot higher frame rates, but I'm not really trying to sell the high frame rate aspect of the APU in this case. I'm just trying to show you that if you want your game to look pretty and you're okay with 30 FPS, you can even play some super modern racing style games and get by. And again, we have to keep price in consideration here because it's easy to look at a title like this and think, wow, you know, modern racing game, only 30 FPS, that's no good. But you've got to also remember that for the price of this APU, you're getting six modern Zen 3 CPU cores. That's essentially a 5600 or 5600G packed in at really no crazy amount of money. So even if you were wanting to play a kind of a worst case scenario game like this, 30 FPS is still doable. And if that's not good enough for you, you can always drop the in-game resolution and get much higher frame rates. But just for kicks, this is the same game in 720p with ultra low in-game settings, and you can see we're hitting that 60 FPS target no problem. And I'm kind of surprised that ultra low still looks actually decent here. Now the last game I wanted to test was the Rift Breaker, and this one I'm actually playing in 720p right now, which is why our little overlay is a bit bigger than usual. You can see that we're holding above 60 FPS consistently. So this APU I would say is definitely a 720p gamer, and if you're not really all that concerned about resolution and you're more worried about how pretty a game looks, then dropping things down to 720p to kind of make up for that frame rate loss by bumping in-game settings is definitely doable with the 5600G. That's the other thing I wanted to show you. So yes, we are more or less GPU bound, but at the same time, this game is actually still rather pretty to look at, even in 720p, which I didn't really see myself saying when I began filming this, but it's really not bad. Everything is very fluid. We've got some extra in-game settings bumped in as well. You've got the moving scenery in the background, all the moving foliage. Looks really nice for a game like this. Now, when it comes to other aspects of this APU, including power draw, I think you'll be pleasantly surprised. Power draw for this entire rig while running the Dirt 5 benchmark, which again is one of the heavier titles for this APU, was under 80 watts, almost throughout the entire thing. That is extremely impressive given the kinds of graphical potentials we're seeing in this benchmark. We're not running in 480p or something extremely unreasonable given the amount of money we're spending. This is 1080p here, and this title is only pulling at the most 75 or so watts from the wall. Again, this is the entire system pulling power, which means that the 65 watt TDP target for the 5600G is pretty much spot on from AMD. And these power savings can be passed along to the power supply as well, which will in turn lower the effective budget of a build like this. You don't need a 600, 700, or 800 watt power supply to power a 5600G build, assuming you also are not including a discrete graphics card. If you're just running the APU itself, even a 500 watt unit, to be honest, is a bit overkill, seeing as though the entire build under a heavy load is only pulling around 80 watts. And again, as we were saying earlier, because the thermal design power of this chip is around 65 watts, which is relatively low, we don't need to spend extra money on a beefier CPU cooler. The one you get in the box, the Stealth cooler, is actually pretty darn good and quiet under load. So check this out. I've been running the Dirt 5 benchmark in this machine for over 20 minutes. I've got the lavalier mic in my hand, and I'm going to put it right next to the Stealth cooler here. You can barely hear it. That is insane. If you just ask anybody with their eyes closed if this system was under load or not, they'd tell you it was at idle. It is an incredible cooler considering you don't have to pay any extra for it when you buy a 5600G. And I suppose I should also note that while we were running this Dirt 5 benchmark over and over, CPU temperatures never reached 70 degrees Celsius. In fact, our GPU temperatures were even lower than that. Now, a few pointers, especially for those looking to build a very similar system to this one here, utilizing one of AMD's latest APUs like the 5600G. You're gonna wanna put an emphasis on your memory kit. A few pointers I like to give my viewers. First off, stick to two sticks. Don't drop down to a single stick, although it might be enticing from a price perspective to just buy a single DIMM of DDR4. Going with two DIMMs will allow you to run dual channel, which will greatly benefit your APU. And as for frequency and timings, I like to stick in the ballpark of around 3000 to 3600 megahertz and CL16, CL18, at the most CL20. Typically your timings will follow suit with your cache latency. You'll also want to select a motherboard that includes a display connector you intend on using for your setup. If you need an HDMI port, but your motherboard doesn't have an HDMI port, well, that's gonna be a problem, right? Same goes for DisplayPort. If you really wanna use one of those, you'd have to add a discrete card, and that kind of defeats the purpose of buying an APU in the first place. And one more thing about motherboards and 5000 series APUs from AMD, Compatible BIOSes. As a result of AM4 being so versatile, a lot of these BIOSes tend to overlap in terms of CPU and APU compatibility. A lot of older, especially like B450 and even some earlier B550 boards, will not have support for 5000 series APUs out of the box. You'll want to check the retailer listing before purchasing if you don't have a CPU that you can't already throw in here that's already compatible by default to update the BIOS with. Remember, you'll need a CPU in the socket in order to flash the BIOS, but it needs to be a compatible CPU. Otherwise, the other solution is to buy a board that has BIOS flashback or equivalent functionality. That means you won't need a CPU in the socket in order to update the BIOS to the most recent one for 5000 series APU support. And maybe just one more pro tip while we're here, save your box. These things look cool. So hopefully by this point, we've shed a bit of light into the capabilities of the Ryzen 5 5600G from AMD and whether or not it's worth your hard-earned. I happen to think that it is. If it wasn't worth it, and I truly believe that, I'd look like an idiot making this video. These two SKUs from AMD are the most powerful desktop-grade APUs on the planet. It's not even a question. You're gonna get better graphical performance in this CPU and its bigger brother, the 5700G, than you will from anything that's ever been released by AMD or its competitors ever. And you'd think, with a title like that, you'd be paying quite a bit more than what you actually will be from a retailer like Amazon or Newegg. This thing is extremely efficient. I mean, it literally sips on power. It is so incredibly quiet. Yes, even when paired with the stock in the box Wraith Stealth cooler, which is, I'm still wrapping my head around the fact that AMD actually gives us decent coolers. Like, we are not used to that from competitors one bit. And to top things off, this is actually a really freaking good CPU and APU. I mean, if you were buying this just for the CPU capabilities alone, look no further than Ryzen 5 5600, 5600X benchmarks. That's basically what you're getting in this package with slightly altered frequencies, but on top of that, you're getting a pretty capable GPU as well. You can get by in even modern titles with this thing, which is something that I honestly didn't expect going into this. And to top things off, it's actually affordable. It doesn't break the bank. And look, AMD is not saying that this is gonna be the end-all be-all best gaming solution ever. That's not what this is marketed as. Quite the contrary, actually, it is intended to be a budget solution. For those who are very budget conscious, looking to spend no more than about maybe $400 or $500 total in US dollars on a gaming PC overall, this thing definitely fits the bill, and it means you don't have to struggle to find a discrete graphics card at a decent price, which is proving near impossible. With all of that said, if you want to learn more about the Ryzen 5 5600G or even the Ryzen 7 5700G, both from AMD, be sure to check out relevant links in this video description, as well as where to buy them, although I'm sure you know where to find them. These things are in stock, at least as of time of filming, they're in stock. They're not suffering from to the same extent that their discrete counterparts are. And that's an awesome thing, because not only are these relatively affordable, but you can buy them right now. There's nothing stopping you. And even if you just wanna buy one of these to kind of get you by until things subside, which who knows when that'll happen, but still, it's not bad. It's really not. It's not a 4K APU, okay? That's not what AMD's marketing this as. I think that would be a pretty awful experience. I don't know why they would do that anyway. But for 1080p and 720p gameplay, this is good enough for a budget build. Point blank, you don't even need to consider a discrete graphics card. You don't need to look on eBay, haggle. You don't need to cross your fingers and hope that something on Amazon or Newegg is going to be in stock soon. You can just buy this, because it's readily available and it's not being scooped up en masse by scalpers and miners and whoever else. It's just a really good value. And best of all, it targets the budget conscious builder out there who's perhaps been hit the most by this current market. That's all for this one. Be sure to let me know in the comment section below what you thought of this video and what you'd like to see next here on the channel. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. If you aren't subscribed, get subscribed, and I will catch you in the next one. My name is Greg. Thanks for learning with me.